In this current climate, community is the most valued asset. People building and lending skills to create something from the unexpected. Family-run business Fruits of the Forage are making big moves in this direction.
I'm Archie, I'm the youngest of the three brothers at Fruits of the Forage. In our veg boxes, we bring you the best of Cheshire and Lancashire farmers. We deliver it to your door the very next day after it's picked. This veg is fresh and we package it by hand, so it's got minimal plastic packaging. We pick wild greens that people are then able to experiment and cook with, that unless they had the knowledge of foraging that we've built up over the last 6 years, they'd never be able to get these ingredients.
Knowledge built and ready to share, these foragers have courses for the whole family. You could be plucking pears in no time. And in the spirit of the unexpected, we left Macclesfield after hijacking some veg boxes for two unsuspecting challengers. And once loaded up, we made our way back to the land of United, City and Chicken Splits, sunny old Manchester. And now to introduce our challengers, Chimpo, label boss, lyricsman, DJ, producer, Lord of the Clash, and Gyardem Sugar.
I'm excited, I'm scared, anxious, I'm over the moon. There's a big box of food, I think it's all vegetables, and that is it all vegetables? Yeah. It's all vegetables. And so I've got some off-key stuff, I've got some chickpeas, and I've got some next Lebanese shawarma spice. Well, I've been cooking some stuff on some meatballs and that, and it's been lame. Yeah. Flavour matching, I'm a selector. It should taste good, even if it's odd.
Eh? And in the green corner, we have Levi, also known as LC. Not only can you sample this man's music, but you can also sample his culinary expertise at a power plant pop-up near you.
It's exciting. The brother come with some energy, you know, so I'm excited to, you know, get involved and just participate, you know. So the items that I've brought, some coconut milk, some of my own curry seasoning. I'm just excited to be here.
Chimpo in the kitchen.
Leaving the experts to their business, we'll let Chimpo get his hob on, get his water on the boil. Don't know whether that's a squash or a pumpkin, that posh, that squamkin. Let's check in on Chimpo.
So far, off the chisel. I'm winging it in it, it's not a recipe I've done before and that. So I'm hoping, you get me, some Lebanese gods just channeled down to me some bad boy recipe that I didn't even know I had in me or whatever. I might even put some pomegranates on top of the stew like a
Lord. I understood that.
Need salt, man.
No measurements required, Chimpo. No measurements required. Mmm, swish. Following the food to the table, it's time to meet our judges, local and international rap mogul Sleazy F Baby. From all the way down Silk Road, Macclesfield, Freddie Forage, representing Fruits of the Forage. And finally, we have the boss man at Manchester's favourite sit-down Caribbean food spot, Esno's Good Food.
Gentlemen.
What is that? Great!
He's doing bits, okay.
The pomegranate's going as well, yeah, okay.
All right.
Aesthetics, yeah, man.
Yeah, man.
Mm.
I'm digging it, Chimpo.
Yeah. Not too
I'm
spicy
as well, like, nice.
Yeah.
Lots of fruity flavours there as well. Mm.
Gentle.
Yeah.
But warm and hearty. And you've done a fine job, you have, yeah, Chimpo.
Oh, not when your mouth's full of warm and hearty, Fred. Yeah. The concentration on us.
See, that's a proper rogue salad, that is.
It looked it.
You don't see these, the cabbage salad out there.
Rogue salad. Mm. I ain't even know grapes are going salad.
Right. You've done a good job with that squash.
Yeah.
Squash?
Yeah.
I thought it was a pumpkin.
And me.
Yeah, boom. It was exciting, it was turbulent, it was dangerous. There was moments I was on the edge. There was the rice was nearly burning. Whoa, off the pan. Saved. Mission accomplished. All the water was coming out of the stew. Don't worry about it. Bit more water. Sorted. There was a can opener situation. No can opener. 10 minutes. Where's the can opener? Ah! Found it. Sorted. Little penknife one. Swiss Army knife. Don't worry about it. Crank that. It was all of these things. I had a lovely time.
Levi in the kitchen.
Cool and quietly confident, packing a bottle of ionized water and the disposition of a dangerous man, Levi is ready to start his process. This could be tight, Chimpo.
Hitting high heavens with the whole team. Universal bars, we all got those scars though. Pluto and Mars, we we sure is some stars though. Humanity, system trying to break with school of vanity. No, I don't want a snake, we give you apples from the tree. And why they wanna spray, we kill us metaphysically. 2020 vision, now it's time to break free from these chains while we wrapped up. And little bro say he's strapped up, say he can't get slapped.
Secret curry seasoning, what is in that, Levi? Both contestants making good use of that squonkin. Catching up with Levi, see where he's up to in his process. Oh, might be a bit small, that, brother.
I've enjoyed the process. You've had to try something new, get creative, you know, doing a few things that I've never done before, ingredients that I've never worked with, you know, but nevertheless, you know, this is, it's exciting.
I think he revised Levi's dish.
Can I bust this down?
Do you feel
yeah, man.
Get involved. Yeah, man, it's real clean, the pasta.
Mm.
And natural.
The sauce is very tight.
Now, you've got loads of different textures there.
The fritter steals the show.
Yeah,
right. The fritter is a showstopper.
Facts. And whatever chutney is on top of it, I can't remember what's
Fruits of the Forest chutney.
That's it right there, man.
Me, I tell you what, you're doing so right.
Judgment time.
For me, yeah. See the fritter? The fritter was the best thing all around. But obviously it was the curry as a whole versus the fritter. But in the end, I've not stopped talking about the fritter.
Chimpo's Lebanese curry was absolutely magic. And like the veg in there was all cooked.
Yeah, the grapes. Yeah. Like, this is what I'm saying. There was a lot going on that day.
Cabbage salad with the grapes.
Cabbage
and
grapes. And the rice,
and
the basmati rice.
There's a lot of talking, boys.
Yeah. The fritters have taken the biscuit.
Yeah.
Fritter wins all.
Fritter wins all.
You should be on day, Fred.
Bullshit. I'm not having it. Right, I'm only joking. I was winging it. I winged it with my dish. I did a wild thing. Come off all right, you know what I mean? My man smashed it. I seen him come through the plates and that. You know what I mean?
Don't
I had
shoot.
To stand back and say, yo, he had the master chef plate. You know what I mean? He had the master chef plate. I had to come dine with me plate. Good food all around, good company, good times, good competition.
Good man.
Yeah, man, it was a good event, man. It was a good evening. Like I said, you know, Chimpo, you know, he did some great work with the stew and the curry because guys were talking about it, you know, both
it's in the eyes.
In there, just enjoyed the process and, you know, it is what it is, you know, at the end of the day, you know, the guys enjoyed both of the dishes.
That's what winners say.
They enjoyed the fritters, they enjoyed the stew, so, you know, that's how it goes, man. So, yeah, big up, you know, to everyone involved. It was a great event.
And there you have it. Our judges have made their judgments. Our champion is our champion. And our chimpo is our chimpo. Join us on our next episode of Foraged N Fired as we continue our search for the ultimate champion. More challenges, more judges, more victories, more scrans.